treatment for viral hepatitis will depend on the virus causing the hepatitis in the first instance. For example, hepatitis A and hepatitis E tend to be acute and self-limiting infections, meaning they get better themselves. The difficulty with viral hepatitis are the viruses which cause more chronic disease and lead to chronic liver disease. These are specifically hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and in some cases, hepatitis D or Delta virus, which is a super or co-infection with hepatitis B. For hepatitis C, we have new, very effective antiviral drugs which can eradicate the virus in up to 95% of patients in relatively short periods of time, sometimes with treatment for only 8 or 12 weeks. Hepatitis B is more challenging in that we're not able to really deliver a cure when we treat it. And what we're actually trying to do in this case is virally suppress the patients or reduce the virus to very low levels where we don't think it causes harm. This means that in hepatitis B, quite often patients will be on medications for a very long period or even lifelong in some cases. However, there are significant changes afoot with new drugs in development, which should improve our ability or chances of achieving a cure in hepatitis B. Also, we are still using pegylated interferon in a proportion of patients, and this works by boosting the host's immune response against the virus, essentially helping the patient to control the virus themselves. But we'll see a lot of developments over the coming years in the treatment of hepatitis B, as this is really an area of very rapid development.